Get ready to match the star. Dick Martin, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Jody Donovan, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flay as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here he is, the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers!
Thank you, Johnny Olsen and Fred. You're all ready, right?
Oh, Gene, yeah. Yes, indeed.
I greet you one and all, especially this beautiful young singer-actress who's
Thank
making her
you.
Debut with us this week, Jody Donovan. What?
Oh, I thought you were talking to me. You said young, beautiful
young
singer,
actress,
dancer,
yes.
actress, all that. I thought yes. she must
Remember,
be talking to me.
Remember, you're just over 28.
I wish.
Now, let's say hello to our two players, Janice Valentine and Penny Barrow here. This lady is our current champ. She's won a total of $1,200, and she's being challenged by Penny. They've both had their first round questions, and Penny, you've had both of your questions, and you've matched five of our celebrities, and you've got one question to go. You've got to match four to achieve a tie, five to win your second game. Tune in 1 minute and 5 seconds and see how this game turns out. Oh, but where have you been? Okay, I push this button and reveal our second and final round question. This is for you, Janice. Remember, four to tie, five to win. Who does not play?
Smart.
Jody does not play because you matched her in the
Jody
first round.
Jody doesn't play. Oh,
Jody.
Oh, that seems a shame.
Yes, it does seem
we'll
a shame. Here it is. At the party, they didn't have any finger bowls.
Ah.
So all the guests washed their fingers in blank bowl. There were no finger bowls at the party, so all the guests washed their fingers in the blank bowl.
Hello.
Hello there.
Have you made the reservation?
Yes, I have.
Oh,
it's
good.
All set.
What time are we expecting?
Midnight.
Ooh, that's the witching hour.
That's right.
Midnight.
That's right, midnight. Okay, here we go, Janice. You ready?
Ready.
I'll give it to you once again. Think about it carefully now. At the party, they didn't have any finger bowls, so all the guests washed their fingers in the blank bowl.
Toilet bowl.
I'm not going to your party. What do you say there?
Well, it was New Year's Day, so she washed her fingers in the Rose Bowl.
In the Rose Bowl. Oh, you are a weirdo. You really are weird. Brett, what do you say? Gotta match everybody to stay in the game now, Janice. All the remaining ones.
I say he's never right, but he's so cute. Who
he
cares?
Is cute, yes.
To hell with Dolly. It's you and me, hon. I said turlet.
Okay. Thanks for Janice. 5-2 the score at this moment. Charles?
I said la toilette bowlée.
Oh, now the score is 5-3. You're creeping up on him, Janice. Let's go over here to Richard. What do you say, Richard?
I used a clinical term, toidy.
Toidy. 5-4 the score. One more match and we get a tie.
Hey, I'm sorry, I said soup.
Soup bowl. So, Penny Barrow wins the game. Come on down, Penny. Congratulations. Okay. All right, you stand by here for a second. Do your little dance while I'm talking here. It's perfectly all right with me. Now, Janice, you're going to leave here with $1,200. And we congratulate you.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. I enjoyed myself very much.
Good. Janice Valentine.
Bye.
Goodbye, my dear. How'd it feel?
Great. Absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, you... you hit me.
Oh, sorry.
That's all right. That's a cute outfit you're wearing.
Thank you.
Those
thank
are
you.
Old-fashioned overalls, huh?
Sort of.
Yeah. Yes, right. Because they never looked that good on me. I don't know that. Now, you've done well with our celebrities here. Now we're going to see how you do with your ESP and concentrate real hard and see what you can do with a whole big studio audience as we get to the Big Money Super Match here. We polled a recent audience and we got their best response to this. Blank of America. Now, the answer that group gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match their second most frequently given response, you get $250, and then their third, you get $100. Now, whom do you call on for some help here?
Richard.
Well, calling on me is like money in the Bank of America.
Bank of America is what he said. There's one.
Fanny, some people that I'm very fond of, the Boy Scouts of America.
Very nice. Boy Scouts of America.
They hate me.
No, the Boy Scouts love you, too. I've gotten a lot of mail from the Boy Scouts saying, get Fanny.
Little blue-eyed devil.
One more.
Brett. Oh, I've got two.
Let's stand up for this, sugar.
The United States of America.
So you've got United States of America, Boy Scouts of America, and Bank of America. Now, you can choose one of those, or if you've got a better idea, give us that.
United States of America.
Hey. The United States.
United States of America.
All right. You're from Virginia, right?
Yeah.
Okay, honey. She's from Virginia. All right. We're looking for the United States of America. Let's find out where it is at. Let's find out if it is at under the $100 response. Voice of America. All right. This little lady, Pay Barrel, is seeking the United States of America under the $250 response. Bank of America is Richard's answer. All right, that may be a good omen here, Penny. Let's find out now. Last chance for the United States of America. Stand up and be counted if you're under the $500 response. Yeah! Hey.
Congratulations, my dear!
So, that means, Penny, you've got a grand total at this moment of $600. But more important than that, you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect that, you've got to match one celebrity, and this has to be an exact match. And it's time to choose that person now.
First of all, I love you, Brett, but I want to try Richard.
You'll be at my place, darling, at 9. Come as you are. Your wish is granted. Now, who are you going to choose for this game?
She's choosing you, Richard.
Oh, all right.
All right, stand here facing me, Penny, honey. All right, here it is. Now concentrate on this real hard and see if you can get a little ESP going. Order from you to Richard. This is it, Richard. Worth $5,000. Blank buttons. B-U-T-T-O-N-S. Blank buttons. Or blank buttons. Okay, he's finished. Now, Penny. Now you think and concentrate. What do you think he wrote on that card? Blank buttons.
I can't think of anything.
Oh, yes, you can. Now, wait a minute. Blank buttons.
Buttons.
Just relax.
Buttons. Just relax. Take a deep breath and you'll think of something. Look at it. Does that suggest anything to you?
Coat buttons. I can't
coat
think
buttons.
Of anything.
All right. Well, sometimes you draw a blank on this program, and she got coat buttons, but it's better than saying nothing now. Richard, what do you say?
See, there's so many kinds of buttons now. I thought of a person, red buttons.
Red buttons.
Oh, yeah.
You what?
I should have thought of him.
Yeah. Well, he's a very popular actor, isn't he? Is that what you would have thought of, audience? Collar button. Collar button. There are a number of good choices.
The moment you start going for, you could be brass buttons.
Brass buttons, collar buttons.
But a person. That's the only buttons I know.
Right. Okay, now, Penny, you've got your 600. You're going to meet another player in a moment or so, but right now we want to do a little business with America. This is it. Here we are, back again. Let's welcome a new player, shall we? Say hello to Judy Mann.
Ho, ho, ho! Judy Mann! Hello, Judy Mann!
Now, what's the Judy Mann story?
Well, I live in Encino. I'm a secretary.
Yeah.
And I'm very single.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, candidate.
You have pretty eyes.
Thank you.
Yes. They're green, are they?
They're blue.
Blue, oh.
I'm a winner
just a
every
second,
time.
Judy.
Blue, green,
blue, blue eyes.
No, just plain blue.
Whatever you say.
All right. Okay.
Very single.
Yes, that's enough.
I'm just getting this down.
Yes.
Penny also single.
Yes.
Singer, West Virginia. Carry on.
West Virginia.
Yeah. All right. Now, are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
You know how to play this game?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll push this button and ask you as a challenger to make a selection.
B.
B. Here we go. Everybody plays. Ready to play. The Wentworths are so rich.
Yeah.
Let me tell you how rich they are. When they ran out of firewood, they threw their blank into the fireplace. Now that's rich. Isn't that rich?
Wood.
Ran out of firewood. They threw their blank into the fireplace. Yes. Mighty rich.
I can only think
that's
of...
That's rich.
We are so rich.
That's rich.
When we ran out of firewood, we threw our blank into the fireplace. Didn't think a thing of it. Excuse me, madam. You nuzzled me with your chair. For a moment, I was aroused.
Is anybody okay. Not finished so I can read? Well,
you finished. Everybody's finished. Judy Mann. The Wentworths are so rich. When they ran out of firewood, they threw their blank into the fireplace.
Their money.
Their money. That's not bad. I didn't think of that. That's now that I think of it, though. I hear it is not a bad answer. What do you say?
I said their uncle.
Their uncle.
Now that's
why.
Rich.
Now, wait a minute.
That's
why would
rich.
They throw an uncle in?
Well,
I've got to find out about that.
Because the man was obviously rich and they'd collect his insurance.
Oh, I see. Yes.
Crafty.
But that would make them more rich than they were before.
I never thought of that.
Yes. Oh dear me. Brett.
Remember what I said before about he was so cute we didn't care how rotten his answers were?
Yeah. Now
you take it back. I said they threw their nice antiques.
There's
in
a
there.
Good answer. Yes, indeed. The antiques. They're Louis.
The uncle owned the antiques.
Through their Louis XIVs.
I said furniture.
Furniture is another good response there. All right, Jody's going to give us a good response, too. I can feel it in my bones.
I said furniture.
Furniture is good. This little lady here, Judy Mann, she said they're so rich that when they ran out of firewood, they threw their money into the fireplace. What do you say, Saul?
I say I'd give $10,000 to be a millionaire.
You would?
Not right at this moment. I wish I had an answer. I said furniture, though.
Furniture?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that seems to be a logical answer there. Now, Fanny, what'd you say?
I'm sorry, honey. I said furniture.
Furniture. If you'd said furniture, you'd be in clover now, which would be very unusual for a first-round question. Right, Penny?
Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah. You ready for yours?
Yes.
This is your first rounder. Gloria said... She said,
Hallelujah.
No, she didn't say that. I just spent a weekend with Gunga Dinghy. And boy, was it painful. Not only does he have a bed of nails, he also has a blank of nails. Not only does he have a bed of nails, he has a blank of nails.
I hate that.
You don't like that question?
I just hate, but you look cute as a bug's ear.
Thank you. This suit has stripes that goes both ways. Have you noticed? But don't pay any attention to that right answer there.
That's go. What I've always heard about you.
Oh, I dropped the question. Excuse me. Here we go. Everybody here ready?
No.
No. Not only does he have a bed of nails, he also has a blank of nails.
Oh, wait. Oh.
Put it in. All right.
Who put it in?
You ready? Ready.
I got it.
Penny. Gloria said, I just spent a weekend with Gunga Dinghy, and boy, was it painful. Not only does he have a bed of nails, he also has a blank of nails.
Head of nails.
A what?
Head of nails.
A head of nails.
Yeah, head of nails.
Yeah.
Nah.
This is a hard question, isn't it?
It really is.
Yeah. If a good answer comes up, unlikely, but if one comes up, I'll let you know. What do you say?
Gunga Din is only famous for one thing, and that is playing the bugle, so he had a bugle of nails.
You said that on that card? Hey, bugle of nails.
Be that as it may.
Right. Dick, you are going downhill.
Thank you.
Rapidly.
What do you say, Brett?
I say, be that as it may, we will now still sing Nearer Thy God to Thee. I said rug and or floor of nails.
Rug and or floor of nails. Okay.
You're not thrilled with that?
Not thrilled with that, right.
No head.
Let's see.
Going down further, slipping beyond control, a toilet seat.
Yes, sir. That's a funny, rotten answer if I've ever heard one. Jody.
I say that he was a terrible kisser and had a mouth of nails.
Oh, was that hurt? That would be very painful. Now, Richard, show him a reasonably sensible answer, if you would, please.
Just a second. I'll see if I've got one.
Look through your files there and see what you can come
up with. What was the question?
Boy, was it painful. Not only does he have a bed of nails, he also has a...
I said torso.
Of torso of nails.
When they embraced.
Yes, when they embraced, it hurt.
Oh, better than bugles, surely.
Yes, certainly. Oh, yes, indeed.
I appeal to your sense of fair play.
Yes, I agree. Fanny, what do you say?
I say I can hear the sound of my after equity and SAG card being ripped. I said body.
Body.
Sorry.
Now, folks, I appeal to you. What about a pillow of nails?
Pillow?
Not only does he have a bed of nails, he has a pillow of nails.
That's you can't put pillow.
Well, I'm. If she had had the decency to say pillow.
Aha, well, if she'd said torso, I would have matched
her. Bugle.
Yeah.
No, she wouldn't say bugle.
Yeah, good point.
What are some of the other good answers? A chair of nails. What about that?
Oh, that
good.
Stinks.
Pillows and chairs. You're all fired.
Obviously an
impossible. Get out of this studio.
One day we'll go.
All right. Listen.
Let's go.
In round one, we ain't got nothing, have we? But round two is coming up. Do not despair. All right, we've got a little message for you. You hurry right back. One, go. Here we are. Yeah, are you ready, ladies? Round two coming up. No score. We'll see what this brings now. Judy?
It's up again. To you.
Be again. Na-da-dee-da-dum. Are you ready?
Yep.
Everybody plays because no one was matched.
We're better this time. Yeah.
At the chapel, Susan said...
Oh, I love church stories.
She said, you can tell this is a shotgun wedding. The bride is wearing a blank. You can tell this is a shotgun wedding. The bride is wearing a blank. You know what a shotgun wedding is, Judy? Okay, just want to make sure.
They don't have them anymore.
Well, it's an old expression that means a certain thing. All right, put it in the slot, and away we go. Ready?
Yes.
Ready. Judy, at the chapel, Susan said, you can tell this is a shotgun wedding. The bride is wearing a...
Judy?
Again?
You know what a shotgun wedding is?
Yeah.
What is a shotgun wedding?
A wedding where he insists that he marry her. Her father insists.
That's, for certain reasons, right? Yeah.
Oh,
At the chapel, Susan said, you can tell this is a shotgun wedding. The bride is wearing a...
Maternity dress?
A maternity dress. Why do you look puzzled, Dick?
I frankly didn't think it got that far, so therefore I said, was wearing a holster.
I'm hopeless. Yeah.
He is fading fast.
Demented.
We must get the doctor for poor Dick Martin here. What do you say?
Honey, he just can't catch up.
But he loves you.
I love him. Well, now, I believed in free love. I went to my mother in Portland, Maine, and I said, I believe in free love. She fainted and put a white streak in her hair. But in spite of that, I said maternity dress.
Hey, maternity dress. That's one for the lady. Charles?
I went a different route. I said bulletproof veil.
A bulletproof veil. That's very good. A bulletproof veil. I find that rather amusing, don't you, Jody, darling?
Yes, and I have maternity dress.
You have a maternity dress, and we'll travel.
Well, for those who like bulletproof veil, I have a bulletproof dress.
A bulletproof dress.
Yes.
Okay, Fanny, we're up to you. Maternity dress is what we're looking for. This is a shotgun wedding. The bride is wearing a maternity dress.
I didn't understand this until a year ago when Brett told me about her first marriage. I said maternity
dress. Maternity dress. So that's three for you, and you'll have a chat at it when we come back from this message on the dress. Okay. You ought to see the scene here. One floor director is standing here pointing to camera two. You're coming out on camera two. The other one is standing over there saying, you're coming out on camera three. And I'm going, what's that, camera two? Listen, we got to cool it now. Can you come back next time?
Absolutely.
Can you come back next
time?
We'll try. You'll try, yes. The score at this moment is 3-0. And when we pick up, you've got to match three celebrities to achieve a tie, and four, however, will win another game for you. Ladies, we'll look forward to seeing you again soon. You were all just splendid.
Thank you.
Now, some of you will come back, and some of you may never, ever come back again.
Amen.
All right, these are the ones who are coming back.
Marvin Hamlin, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Isabel Sanford, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
How do you like them apples? Join us next time.